Now that we've set up our server on AWS and we've created the database and the superuser, we're almost ready to test our API. The last thing we need to do is add the domain name of our server to our allowed hosts setting in our Django project settings file. We're going to take this opportunity to add the host to our project, and then I'll show you how to pull updates to your code to the server. So if you ever want to deploy new changes that you've made to the API, I'll show you how to do that. All right, so let's get started. We're going to start by loading up the Atom editor and opening up the settings.py file, which is within our profiles project. In this file, locate the allowed hosts list right here, and then head over to your AWS console and copy the name of the public DNS that we have for our server. If you head back to the settings file, then we need to create a new string in this list. So create a new, open up a new speech marks and paste in the domain name for our server. This allowed host file is just a security feature. So when you're running Django on a server, it only lets you access it by the domain names that you've added to the allowed host directory or the allowed hosts list. So if you wanted to restrict different domain names, then they're already restricted by default, and you need to add the domain names that you want to allow to access the project. So put the domain name of the AWS server and then save the file. And then we're just going to do a git commit on our project. So open up a git bash window or a terminal window. And then we're going to commit our changes by typing git add dot and then git commit hyphen am. And we'll just say added AWS server allowed hosts. All right, hit enter. And then we need to push this to GitHub. So we go git push origin. This is going to push the change up to GitHub. And then what we need to do in a different terminal window, make sure you're connected to our server on AWS. What we're going to do now is we're going to pull the change that we just made down to our project, and then we're going to restart the server process so that the changes come into effect. So on the server, type sudo hyphen I. Actually, seems I've disconnected from the server, so I'm just going to reconnect. Copy the domain name and then connect by typing SSH Ubuntu at the server name, and then type sudo hyphen I to switch to the root user. And then we're going to navigate to the location of our project on the server. So that's /usr/local/apps/profiles REST API. And then within inside this directory, type git pull. And you can see that it's pulled down the one change to our settings.py file that we just made. Now we need to restart the supervisor process so our change comes into effect. So type supervisor CTL restart all. You can see it stops and starts the process. And now we should be able to test our API. So let's just make sure that this works. Paste this in here. Okay, so you can see that it's taken us to the root of the API. It's got these options. So that's how you add to the allowed host of the settings file, and that's how you pull changes down from GitHub onto the server. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.